I have that approach, like, you know, because here's the thing. When I first started out, I was a fan. You know, and when you're a fan, you look at, you have a different outlook. But then when you jump in the game, like I am now, you're like, hold on. I can't be no fan. I'm a fighter. You can't be a, you know, it's hard to be a fan. If you're a fan and a fighter, then something has to give. And I was like, you know what? Fuck being a fan. I respect my coworkers, my other fighters. And I like what they do, but I'm not a fan, I'm a fighter. You know what I'm saying? And all the rankings, no, I don't get caught in that. Because anybody I know as a fighter, anybody can get beat. I know as an athlete, anybody can lose. Usain Bolt lost to Tyson Gay, I believe, a year ago in the 100-meter dash. And he was supposed to be unbeatable in the 100-meter dash. Joey Chestnut, he beat Kobayashi. And Kobayashi at the time was unbeatable at the eating contest. You know what I'm saying? So anybody in competition, anybody can be defeated. You know what? Here's the thing. I see the thing. I'm like, oh, he's doing... I not just where he's messing up, but I'm like, oh, he's doing this good. Oh, that's just nice. Okay, oh, I like the distance. I like the rhythm. Okay, that's cool. I like that. Oh, okay. Oh, I see that. Oh, I see. Oh, I got... Oh, okay. Bingo. That's all... That's, yeah. Yeah, that's how all fighters are. You know what I'm saying? If you watch the fight, he's like, oh, okay. Oh, okay. Oh, I got him. All fighters. You can get any fighter, and they'll be like, okay. Oh, bingo. It's nice. Okay. I ain't hating on that. He did that. Oh, he fucked up on that. Oh, I see that. But we ain't saying it out loud, you know what I'm saying? But we saying it on mine. And that's how all fighters, you know what I'm saying? The ones that are really competitive, we all think like that. So, you know, when fans like say that, oh, this guy can't be beat, trust me, if John Jones thought that he can't be beat, he wouldn't be training as hard as he does. I heard he's a workhorse. I heard he's a strong work ethic. And if he thought he can't be beat, he wouldn't be training as hard as he does. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of fans got to think that he's a hard worker. We all are hard workers. And he's just doing his thing right now. You know what I'm saying? He's on top right now. So I can't hate on him. But I do see some things. You know what I'm saying? And everybody, you know what I'm saying? And everybody sees things in me. So, you know, it's fighter spirit. Yeah, I've seen some things too. I like a lot of stuff he does. He's a rhythm fighter, time fighter, and he's a momentum fighter. But I've seen some things in footage. But me, it just takes like two fights. I can watch two fights to figure you out. And then after three or four, I master you. You know what I'm saying? To a certain extent. So, you know, I've watched a few of his fights, and I'm like, okay, bingo, I got it. If I let him like bring off a string of strikes and him getting the motion and him feeling good, then anytime a fighter is feeling good. Like, and gets into the you know, he's on fire mode, like NBA Jams, you know what I'm saying? He's on fire, yeah. Then they're hard to beat. And there's some people like that, like John Jones, momentum fighter, because, you know, you'll see him, he'll start off, he'll land one strike clean, land second strike clean, third strike, he's flaming, you know what I'm saying? He's going, he's right there, he's on fire. Same thing with Rashad. Rashad will be bouncing, bam, bam. He's on fire. You know what I'm saying? Some people like that. They're momentum fighters, and they're hard to beat. So you got to stop them from gaining the momentum in the fight. Man, you know what? I try to get him, you know, I like Lorenz Larkin, man. I try to get him an up-to-date cell phone. He, you know, he's on that cricket plan, and he has a flip phone. Actually, it's that Zach Morris phone from Saved by the Bell. You know what I'm saying? Thick, the brick, yeah. And I was like, we was talking to him because he couldn't get phone reception. And I was like, look, why don't you text the person? He's like, oh, text? What's that? Because, you know, he had that old school phone. He didn't have text messages on his phone. No text messages, though. So, you know, but I like him, man. He's a young kid, man. I like his style. And I like his confidence, though. And that's one thing I like about him, because he called out Herschel. He called out Tito. He called out, you know, everybody, you know. And I like, that's how I was, you know what I'm saying? Even in wrestling, I wouldn't accept the fact that someone's better than me. You know what I'm saying? If they want to be better than me, they got to prove that they're better than me. And that's how some of the fans don't see it like that. They're like, oh, this dude's ranked above you, so you better sit back and let him stand over you. No, you got to prove to me that you're better than me. And even if you beat me, you're still not better than me, you know what I'm saying? Because I'll fight you again. I'll fight you till you have to kill me, you know what I'm saying? You have to kill me to really beat me, you know what I'm saying? And that's how a true fighter thinks.